Now, we've been talking about having a musical performance on the show, but before that performance, I'm going to have a quick sit down with our guest, a performer, of course. Now, of course, he is going to be performing something much later for us to lift our spirits in this holy month of Ramadan. And to do justice to that is Tekunbi. Now, his real name is Uthman Bello. He's an alternative and Afrofusion artist who has a special rendition for us. Great to have you in the studio.
It's great to be here. Awesome. My pleasure.
Now, that name, when you first mentioned Tekunbi, I was confused because I was like, Tekunbi, I don't think I've come across that until you now gave the full one of Omo Tekunbi.
Yeah.
Now, your name is Uthman Bello. How did you come about that as your stage name?
It's a vibe, you know, it's my story, my background inspired the name, basically.
Your background?
My background, yeah. I came from a very, you know, strong background. Islamic oriented, you know, strong background basically. So that inspired the name. Like,
now you know, you just mentioned vibe. Now when people talk about Islamic music, the last thing you think of in most cases is vibe. And it used to be the same for even Christianity. Like people just believe it has to be a certain way and all. So what would you say is you know, Islam's relationship in music is something people always have questions about. From your perspective, what is it like?
You know, Islam is beyond how people look at it. You understand? Islam is a vibe on its own. So my perspective to Islam is for people to understand the fact that you can be creative as a Muslim. You understand? You can do whatever. You did what I'm saying. Like, you can do a whole lot of things. You don't have to be, carved or boxed in a place. You understand? Like, Islam is about fashion. Islam is beautiful. There's a whole lot of things, you know. Mm-hmm. So, Islam is a vibe, and I'm going to let you know. Yeah. There is, man. Just wait. Just wait and see.
Interesting. Now, you know, when you talk about fashionable, especially that word fashion, the first thing that comes to people's minds is the women.
Aye.
Now, most music videos, especially contemporary music videos, you see a lot of females being featured. That's your music video playing on screen right now. Now, you see a lot of females being featured.
All right.
What is your own perspective to that, especially when it comes to Islamic music? Do you think it's something that should be more infused, or something that, no, women are supposed to be like in a particular place where your music is concerned, or even where Islamic music is concerned?
All right, let me put it to you this way. Yeah.
Okay.
If you need to pass an exam, you need to fall in love with the lecturer, the teacher. You understand? You need to find a way. You need to figure out a way to fall in love with them. Islam is a basic need for almost everybody, but a lot of people are afraid to join because they see it as a one way kind of thing. Imagine a lady with the hijab and it's all colorful and beautiful. You know, Islam can be contemporary, can become an urban thing. You dig? Like, if the Prophet was here today, there'll be a lot going on about fashion. It's gonna be beautiful. It doesn't have to be exposing, but it will be beautiful. Think of colors, think of shapes and how to, you know, there's a whole lot of things. Even people that do alternative music, Afro pop, they use people with hijabs and stuff, and it comes out beautiful.
So there's really no problem with having females in your music videos?
There is no problem.
What counts is how they are portrayed.
How they are portrayed, basically.
Now, in several music industries, we see local, you know, not even local, we see, like, for example, Christian acts having songs with secular artists.
Right.
Is that the same thing for you? Would you like to do some kind of collaboration with a secular artist? And if so, who?
Well, I'm definitely going to do so with regular artists, you know. Like, what is regular artist itself? I am an artist, you understand? My career is just starting with a bismillah, basically. You understand? It's just, I'm a Muslim. It doesn't change the fact that I can do other songs. I do other songs, actually. I'm bad at other songs.
Okay.
Dope. Yeah. So, Naira Marley is one of my favorite artists. You'll be surprised.
You heard that. Okay.
You dig. And you will be surprised that, man, I don't want to go into religion, but you would be surprised that even on that day, Naira Marley go first. God will see Naira Marley first before some clerics. You did. Yeah, for real. I'm being serious.
Okay.
I'm being serious.
On a lighter note, though, has anyone ever told you you look so much like Burna Boy? No one has told you that. Well, I'm telling you that.
I keep getting there.
You keep getting that.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll head straight to the kitchen. Mazino is on standby, definitely not looking like Burna Boy.